Yeah, I'm Phillips Nzekwe. I'm an artist of the third dimension, as I call myself. I'm inspired by, an attempt to create what I call a perfect world. People tell me that there's no perfect world, but it's an utopia, condition. So I'm inspired to create a perfect world. And looking at materials around, I just feel I could use them to tell my story. Some artists have really inspired me in the past. The best and the first artist I know is God. Then my mom, who, she introduced me, she opened the door to my artistic odyssey, as I'm still in it now. But I'm inspired also by artists that are free. Artists that are free, when I talk about freedom in terms of material use. So I look at artists like Yayoi Kusama, who's been able to move from one artistic genre to the other. Look at someone like Ayo Mopane, artists who could create light and sound, just move from one genre to the other. They are the ones that basically inspire my creativity. Yes, my technique of artistic creation is what I call plus and minus. Additional and subtractive technique. I just merge everything. So, what I do is for the addition, first of all, that is where it starts. From after the sketch, I put materials together. Like, I model the stuffs, like with clay or with wax. So after that, I now start, I could cast them. But that is all additive. Like you see my concrete sculptures, in my bronze sculptures, in my bone wood sculptures, all these are additive. Then sometimes too, I do subtractive. But creating art through the subtractive technique, could be limiting at times because the material could limit you. And maybe your form, could be limited as a result of the material you're about to use. But I do subtractive, like my subtractive work, you can see my wood carvings and some of my carvings of soap and wax. But these ones are like sketches, if I may say. So everything basically falls under additive, subtractive, and subtractive technique. Yes, for me, in this field of art, what is most important is the cognitive, because one should be able to think and conceive ideas. Then also, the psychomotive skill is very important. But one domain of knowledge, you must underscore is the psychomotor. The affective, because your cognitive before it gets to the psychomotor, that now you've been able to produce a piece of art, you must be able to link it, and that is where the affective domain comes in. So creating art, as far as I'm concerned, is a cognitive, affective, then psychomotor. Although the psychomotor is the one everybody sees, and some people just think art is about drawing. It's not drawing. Don't forget too that a piece of art is an intellectual property. I call my art the art of the third dimension. That is what I call my art, because no matter what I do with my pen or I do with my colors, everything ends up with the form. The process for me is not exhausted till it now becomes a concrete form. So I just call my art, I classify my art under the art of the third dimension. Yes, my practice over time, is being evolving. I believe that art is life. And life, as far as I'm concerned, especially in the 21st century, is about freedom. So I refuse I refuse to be boxed as an artist, you know, confined to a particular medium. Say, Nzekwe is a wood sculptor, Nzekwe is a bronze sculptor, Nzekwe is a fiberglass sculptor, Nzekwe is a junk artist. I refuse, you know, to be confined within a particular medium, because in this world, there are ideas, there are materials, so many materials to play around with. I've worked, I've drawn, I've painted, I've modeled clay, fiberglass, I've done works with, you know, bronze, I've produced my sculpture in bond wood where I had to recycle sawdust and create my sculptures, like the Midnight Dance series and the Pageant series, some of them. I've also created my pieces in wood. Well, I worked in wood between 2011 and 2013, but at the moment I'm back. I want to still revisit. If something tells me there's still much to be done at the moment. Yes, I communicate with my art all the time. If you go to my pages online, my Facebook, my Instagram, my site, there's something I always write. They said, I'm just a simple man, living and enjoying myself in my world of images, imagination, and utopia. So, my thoughts, I always think about having a perfect world. You know, we all like to live in a perfect world. Whether you're black or you're white, you know, irrespective of your religion, we all like this perfect world of peace and, you know, everything working well. But someone once told me that it's not possible, it's an utopia. But what I try to do with my works basically is that I try to create this sort of perfection, you know, for people. Maybe, you know, make people who look at the works could deconstruct and, you know, try to picture this sort of perfection from which I'm coming, which I conceive in my subconscious. My art is the nearest future. I think that art is a global thing. And in the nearest future, I hope that my art will go, you know, travel across the world to that, and the people, irrespective of tribe, race, and religion, should be able to look at my art and make sense out of it.